I'm going to lay out a scenario for you. Here's what's at stake. There are 36 Senate races across the country this year, but really only about a dozen are competitive. So the current math, Democrats have 55. That includes two independents who work with them. Republicans at 45. I'm going to give you a scenario. This is going to make some Democrats mad. But here's how Republicans think they get to a majority. I just changed 6 states: Montana, South Dakota, Alaska, Arkansas, Louisiana, and West Virginia. Those are the 6 states Republicans think they are most likely to win, and they think that helps them get near a majority. Even if that happened, and Democrats say, hey, we're not out of play in Arkansas. Hey, we can still win in Alaska. But hypothetically, let's assume that happened. What would you have? 48 to 45. So how do Republicans get to a majority? Number one, they have to hold their own. They think they will hold Kentucky. This is a very close race, though. Mitch McConnell is the Republican leader. This one is still close to the end. Republicans think, though, they will work this one out. So if that happens, they're up to 49. Now we're looking at these states, 2 Republican states, Kansas and Georgia. The rest are Democratic-held states, Colorado, Iowa, North Carolina, and New Hampshire. I'm going to bring in my friends at this point. I'll start with you, Mr. Fournier. Let's go to Colorado. I was just out there. This one's still close. This is a state where the Republican is slightly ahead. The Democrats think with early voting and the like, they can out-hustle them. Who's going to win here? See, the who's going to win question.
You're the one who taught me at the AP that there's a reason why we have a vote. That is, you know, obviously turnout's going to matter. I think the Hispanic vote obviously favors Udall. I have no idea.
You have no idea, J-Mark?
You can't find a public poll, John, that has Senator Udall winning that race. But Democrats, and even some private data that I've heard about from the GOP, has that race, John, still a 1 to 2 point race in the margin of error, up in the air.
That's why we're having so much fun 2 weeks out. I'm going to come way over here to New Hampshire. The Democrats say they're still slightly ahead in this one. The Republicans are going to try to make this 2-week push to get it. But I'm, for the sake of this hypothetical, I'm going to give this one to the Democrats, just as we play out the math. Now we're at 49-46. North Carolina, this is a race where the Libertarian candidate, this is the pizza delivery guy, could shape this race. Republicans say their candidate, Tom Tillis, has surged in the last 2 weeks, focusing on ISIS and Ebola. Again, for the sake of argument, it's a hypothetical. I'm going to give this one to the Democrats and say Kay Hagan holds on. Now look at what we've got, 49-47 with Colorado, which we're not ready to call here, right? Iowa still in play. I was just out in Iowa again. This one's very, very close. For the sake of argument, Democrats again say they're going to use the Obama machine and out hustle. I'm going to assign this one to the Republicans just for the sake of argument. That would get them to 50, but we would still have 3 states in play. Watch this. What happens if Michelle Nunn wins in the state of Georgia? Republicans are furious at their Republican candidate. Let's assume the Democrats hold on in Colorado and Mark Udall wins that state. What do we have here? 50-49, control of the Senate could come down to an independent in Kansas. If Greg Orman wins this race, if he goes with the Democrats, it's 50-50. Joe Biden, the Democrats would be 51. If he went with the Republicans, it would be a Republican Senate. So the Kansas race, in some scenarios, could decide the whole state of play. I'm going to walk back over here, gentlemen. The question then is, what's it about? I can give you a scenario where the Democrats hold on and have 51 or 52. I can give you scenarios where Republicans get as high as 54, 55, more likely 51 or 52. Does it matter? Will anything change in Washington if we, forgive me, Mitch McConnell and Harry Reid, have a different 70-something-year-old white man controlling the United States Senate?
No. No, no matter how this goes, we're going to have more gridlock and more politics above policy. And I think we're going to have an electorate, as we turn to 2016, that's going to be even angrier, more frustrated, and looking for alternatives outside these two parties.
John, I think you'll see some changes if McConnell is the leader, especially in terms of the appropriations bills. And I think you'll see Senator McConnell and the GOP try to use the bills that fund the government to sort of set policy, recognizing that they can't get stuff done legislatively because the president will veto it. Can they do things through those spending bills, forcing the president's hand, and therefore keep the government open?
My point is,
can they repeal Obamacare with a Democratic president whose name is Obama in the White House?
They can't. No. And what John's saying is right, but it's so incremental, it's not going to matter to one person living outside of Washington, D.C.
So why are we spending $2 billion then?
Because there's a lot of powerful people making a lot of money off this election.
It will matter. Could be a Supreme Court pick. It does matter who's the chairman of the Senate Judiciary Committee and who has the votes on the floor. The president says he's going to take executive action on immigration issues, maybe on environmental issues. It does matter in terms of the fight for that.